they give you a timetable how long you'll probably be?
It depends. It's going to be around from 6 to 9 months to 10 months. It depends. But everything looked great. I feel better than I thought I was going to feel. Mental, body-wise, I feel great. So, yeah, it's going to be a new thing for me, just trying to get ready and get back to work.
I heard your dog got loose. Tell us that story.
Oh, that's funny, Just somebody came to walk the dog because I can't walk him right now. Dwight was at home, and Dwight said, I'll go get him. He escaped. And I was like, Dwight, just take some ham. He'll come back faster. And Dwight thought that was like the funniest thing ever. No, but my teammates, they've been great, man. They've been coming over, hanging out with me, taking me to lunch, stuff like that. So I'm blessed. I'm blessed to have people, my family and teammates and everybody that, and you guys too, that take care of me.
Dennis Smith Jr.
Let's talk about the Mavericks, who are reportedly fielding offers for Dennis Smith Jr.
He and Rick Carlisle, their coach, have not been on the same page.
If they trade him, it's because they're getting something that makes this team better right now.
Now let's head to Dallas, where earlier today, Mavericks coach Rick Carlisle addressed the Dennis Smith Jr. situation. This is the first time he's talked about it. Take a listen.
Dennis Smith is not here, but I want to let everybody know that I reached out to him and his agent last night. Let them know that when he's feeling better, he's welcome to rejoin the team at any time. We would love to have him back.
Well, you can't worry about outside noise too much. There's always rumors every year, usually surrounding every team. So, you just got to be professional about it. Not worry about anything off the floor, but focus on practice, focus on shoot around, and then focus on the next opponent and, as a franchise, we're still trying to win games, trying to chase the eighth spot. So we got to keep it moving in the right direction.
And welcome to the American Airlines Center, Tuesday night basketball, the Mavericks and the Los Angeles.
Dennis Smith will be in the lineup tonight. He'll be starting. We're happy to have him back. We definitely have been missing what he brings to the game in terms of speed, athleticism, and those kinds of things. So we got games to play, and you want to have a full team and a full roster, and we just want to get him out on the court and get back to it.
I don't know a whole lot of what has gone on, and I'm not going to get into a position where I'm going to add more speculative noise to a situation that's probably had too much speculative noise around it at this particular point in time. The things that I do know are that Dennis is a young, talented player who was the ninth pick in the draft last year and is 21 years old. And the Mavs need young talent like that that can help this team get better, can grow together with Luka. I believe very, very strongly that their talents complement each other nicely. You have to have multiple playmakers at this day and age in the NBA to be successful. So, I'm looking forward and hopeful that there will be more time for the Luka-Dennis backcourt partnership, whatever you want to call it, to grow together and get better. And let's see if this thing's going to work, and let's see if this thing is going to be, a key component together of a bright future for the Mavs.
Now Smith down low, beautiful pass to Jordan for the layup from Finney. Smith to Jordan, and the Mavericks take advantage of it against Bradley. In the jump circle to Barnes, back to Doncic. Bradley right there against him, crossing over, stepping back, not shooting. Putting it on the floor, down to 7 to shoot. Inside the arc, trying to find Jordan, couldn't do it. Instead, left of the lane, pops and scores. A 13-footer for Doncic. 15 for him, and the Mavericks by 8, 101-93. As the Mavericks win for the first time on the second night of a back-to-back, they end their 4-game losing streak, a 106-98 win over the Clippers.
I want to talk about the game tonight. If anybody else would like to, it's God for losing streak. And that's the biggest thing right now.
Speed, attacking, shot making, a couple of amazing assists. The one where Doncic got it, threw it ahead to him, and he hit DJ for the alley-oop was beautiful basketball. And really happy for him, Been tough for him being away from his teammates. And he played really one of his best games since he's been here.
to end the losing streak and end the record of losing back-to-backs. I think that's major for us. And it was a real team effort all around tonight. The ball was moving. Everybody competed defensively. We were rotating for one another. So, you know, if we keep these habits moving forward, we'll pick it up.
I know Dennis has worked real hard the last couple of days, and he's young and all that, but you just never know how winded a player is going to be after missing 2 weeks. But he's obviously in great condition.
Off of Jordan to the foul line, in the lane, fakes the pass back out to Jordan, and he scores on the layup. A little Rondo okey-doke there.
Like, I get along with all my teammates. You know, the bad teammate card has never been a thing for me, and I love everybody in the locker room, and I feel like it's a mutual feeling. But they were hugging me because I fell on my ass. It wasn't because I fell, and I didn't know if I was hurt or not, so they was trying to make sure I was straight. That's all that was.
I do. Look, our guys love Dennis. He's a great kid. He's a yes-sir, no-sir guy. You know, he's a wonderful kid, and, you know, and the things that he can do on the court, we can't replace. And so I'm ecstatic that he's back.
Like I said, we got a good win tonight. If anybody want to talk about that, I'm ready.
And welcome to the American Airlines Center. Friday night basketball, the Mavericks and the Detroit Pistons. The first of two meetings in the next 6 days between these teams. They'll play next Thursday at the Little Caesars Arena in Detroit. And Brad Davis, the Mavericks coming off a 106-98 victory over the Clippers on Tuesday night that not only ended a long losing streak, but they did it in such a manner that it looks like there was something for them to build on to. It's off the feed from Jordan, and leaning in, we'll throw it on up for Jordan for the dunk. He was either going to shoot the little runner from below the foul line, but he found Jordan open.
I got confidence in all our guys. I mean, they've all shown the fight. It's been an up and down year, but this team could have folded many times. They have not.
Play by Drummond, looking for the mismatch. He'll try to take him off the dribble himself. Goes right by him and scores with the extension of the foul on Drummond.
You know, in the, I guess it was the second quarter when DJ got his third, you know, I was going to sub for him, and you know, he just said, hey, coach, you know, trust me, I can do this. I said, all right. And then he proceeded to run the floor and get a dunk off a great pass from Smith, and you know, we finished the half well.
And Dodge, but into the hands of Doncic. Mavericks have numbers. Griffin trails it to Kleba, stepping in. They'll let him shoot the three and hit it. And a timeout taken by Dwayne Casey. Furious that there's no foul on the other end. But what a play.
As a head coach, you got to have trust in your players, and they got to know you have trust in them.
The Mavericks 100, the Pistons 97. Doncic down low, slipping the pick, and there's Jordan with the dunk as he got away from Drummond. Great pass by Doncic. Terrific job again by Jordan. And 8 and 6 as he works to his left against Johnson with 4 and 3. He'll drive him, he'll pivot, he'll shoot the fadeaway and hit it from the foul line. And a timeout by Dwayne Casey. A 30-point game for Luka Doncic, his 5th of the season. And the Mavericks with a 7-point lead with 1:19 to play.
You know, we have some home games here. You know, Toronto coming in is, you know, as difficult a home game as you're probably going to get, because of how they're playing this year and how good they are. But it's another opportunity for us to compete and get better.
Like I said, I mean, he's back. We got 2 wins. He gives us a lot, you know? not just in attack. Obviously, he can do a lot of things. But in defense, too, you know, he's aggressive, he's fast, so he helps us a lot.
Matthews to Jordan. Now Smith turns the corner in the lane. Got back to his left hand and scores. Nice move to change the ball position against Ibaka's shot block attempt. Left side skidding a bounce pass to Matthews and back to Doncic. Back to Matthews. Escape dribble. Left side three. That's good. And for Wesley Matthews, the 1,500th career three-pointer up the left side. Dirk with a screen for Doncic. Driving through the lane and on the run. High off the board to score. Moving away from the basket when he let it go. Finds Finney Smith in the corner. He'll drive through the lane to Harris. Out top to Dirk. Releases the three and hits it.
Good ball movement that time by Dallas.
The Mavericks 4-7 from behind the line. Doncic, left side of the floor, drives on Powell, got to the rim, score with a foul, and a chance for three. Beautiful hesitation drive, and Powell just ran right up his hip. From Brunson, Euro stepping on Finney Smith, who got back to block it, and it's picked up by Doncic, 2-on-1 with Brunson, take it all the way, and dunks it! With a big roar to the front row in the American Airlines Center, and a timeout by Nick Nurse. 29 remaining. Doncic with 27, 12, and 8. That will do it as the Toronto Raptors come from behind to defeat the Mavericks tonight, 123 to 120. Not enough tonight as the Mavericks lose a heartbreaker. They fall to 22 and 27, 18 and 7 at home. Toronto improves to 37 and 15.
Get my groove back. Getting used to playing in games again. You don't really realize how much you miss until you're actually missing it. So being out for six games, we believe we can beat anybody. Like you said, there's no more victories. We lost the game. We look forward to playing them again. That's the bottom line. They beat us twice. We ain't beat them yet. So we got our team confidence, and we look forward to playing them again. I told everybody they looking too far into it. Like I said, that's my dog, man. All speculation, I think it needs to stop. You know, I don't even really like answering questions about it because I never thought it was an issue from the jump. So we good. We've been good since the beginning of the year.